Ash's gonna come east stairs, I think. Yep, here she comes, east stairs.
Disable their diffuser. Diffuser located. Check the bomb. Disable the diffuser. You have entered an enemy controlled area. Leave now. You have been spotted by hostiles. Fall back.
What's that?
Hey guys, it's Shock with GG, and in today's video, I'm going to be going over in depth something that a lot of you have been asking me for quite a while now, and that's how to control Ella's Scorpion and which attachments are best for her. So throughout this video, I'll be showing you guys side-by-side comparisons of the different attachments to help show you which perform the best. Now, I've got a secret attachment combo that I found works really well with her, and I don't really see anyone talking about it. So if you'd like to see what that is, be sure to stick around to the end of the video, and I'll be going over it then. Before the video starts though, if you guys enjoyed the video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. This really helps YouTube promote my videos to reach a wider audience so that I'm able to help out more people with this tutorial. I'll also have timestamps throughout the video, so look out for those. But anyways guys, on to the rest of the video. So firstly, I feel as if it's important to go over what attachments I currently use, and this is also what I suggest you run yourself. So first, for my optic, I prefer to run the hollow sight. For the barrel attachment, I run the muzzle brake, and lastly, for the grip, I use a vertical grip. I know that others would recommend using things such as a compensator or flash header for your barrel attachment, and then an angled grip for your grip, but personally, I prefer these attachments, and in this video, I'll go over why. Also, a side note here is that these attachments will also work on console. So what I'm going to do here is show you guys the side-by-side comparison for each barrel attachment. So I'll be switching between the muzzle brake, flash header, compensator, and finally the suppressor. I'm running the vertical grip and reflex on her here, but keep in mind that the optic has no real impact on her recoil unless you take it completely off. I'll be going over this later in the video, as well as a setup where you can run angle grip instead of vertical for those of you who would prefer to ADS quicker. So again, stick around to the end of the video to see the results of that setup. So now we'll be going over the muzzle brake, flash hider, compensator, and finally the suppressor in that order in this side-by-side comparison. So I'll be using this example, which my friend Ebite had used in his video for this as well. And that's basically to pay attention to the first few bullets that are within the reflex itself. This is because the way that you should be trying to control Ella's recoil is to primarily burst fire, especially at longer distances. You do this because the first 11 shots of Ella's Scorpion have reduced recoil compared to the shots following those 11. This means that past those first 11 shots, your recoil, no matter the setup you're running, is going to be significantly more difficult to control. So what we'll be looking for in this comparison is which barrel attachment has the least amount of vertical recoil within just the housing of the reflex sight. So once again, shout out to Ebite for this information. I'll have his video on this linked in the description of my own video here. So firstly, we have the muzzle brake, which is what I had originally recommended you use. So as you can see, this is pretty close to comparison to the other barrel attachments, as all of these really are. So what I like about the muzzle brake, which the other barrels can't provide as well, is the tightness of the first few shots. Now I know that the flash hider provides a very similar recoil pattern, but it takes a much harsher turn into horizontal recoil and a lot faster than it does with the muzzle brake. Now comparing it to the compensator, you can see that you could easily fire at least 2 or 3, maybe even 4 bullets in between the first and second shot if you were using a muzzle brake instead. For this reason, I prefer using the muzzle brake. As I had said earlier, tap firing is the biggest thing when it comes to controlling Ella's recoil efficiently. So for the compensator, I can only shoot 5 or 6 bullets within that reflex housing, with the first 2 having much more recoil. I'd much prefer just to use the muzzle brake. Lastly, we have the suppressor. Now even though the recoil is actually pretty good with this barrel attachment, I'd still recommend you avoid using it. Hey guys, before we continue, I'd like to introduce you to Buff, which is today's sponsor. Buff is an app authorized by Overwolf. Basically, Buff is going to reward you for simply playing your favorite games. Buff works with all sorts of games, including Siege, League of Legends, Valorant, Fortnite, and many more. You'll get rewards by simply letting Buff run in the background while you're gaming. Over time, you'll earn Buff coins to redeem items such as game keys, gift cards, and gaming hardware. All you gotta do is download the app with the link in the description, and then just leave Buff open in the background while gaming. And don't worry, Buff is not gonna affect the performance of your game. But anyways guys, on to the rest of the video. This is because LS Scorpion is already doing 23 damage per shot. So when you throw on a suppressor, you'll go all the way down to 19 damage per shot. This of course goes down drastically as well if you're engaging with someone from any sort of distance. So even though I said tap firing and going for headshots is the most important thing for controlling her recoil, you also have to remember that you aren't likely to hit headshots from all ranges 100% of the time. If the damage decrease wasn't a factor with the suppressor, I'd certainly be running it instead of the muzzle brake. But sadly that isn't the case, so in the end I'll still be running the muzzle over anything else. So now we've gone over all the pros and cons of running each barrel, so I'm really interested to hear what your guys' thoughts are in the comments. So be sure to let me know if you think I'm right or wrong when it comes to which barrel you should be running on her. But as promised, it's time to go over that secret attacher setup that I talked about earlier in the video. So if you've watched me for a while, chances are that you've seen me run this setup before. The attachers for this are as follows: iron sights, muzzle brake, and angle grip. So for whatever reason, running iron sights actually feels as if it has decreased recoil slightly. Now I have no real proof or like concrete evidence to say that this is actually reducing the recoil, but it certainly feels as if it does. So this is a setup that I used to play a lot, especially when I felt like being super aggressive and wanted to peek everything. The angle grip gave me the ability to do all of that extra peeking, and the iron sights made it feel as if I had the same amount of recoil as if I had a vertical grip on. Now the reason I don't always run the setup is because at anything other than really close up with this setup, the iron sights start to really affect your ability to see, especially at range. So I only run this if I know I'll be playing super close quarters. In those cases, this is like a super fun setup that catches a lot of people off guard when they see it. But that's going to be the end of this guide, so I hope you guys all enjoyed the video, and if you did, once again, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. This is really going to help the YouTube algorithm promote my video, which really helps me out a lot. Also, I have merch coming out at 100k subscribers, which I'll hopefully be hitting pretty soon, so be sure to watch out for that. Besides that, you can follow me on any of my other socials. I'll have them all linked in the description. You can also find the link to my Discord in there if you have any other questions regarding this video or any of my others. But anyways guys, I hope that you all have a great rest of your day, and thanks for watching. Operator standing. Op 4 eliminated. So my aim was absolutely horrible, but I did do the 3-man spray down. My leans were all over, but you know what? It's all good.
A dub is it?
Oh! Oh. Good night! Yo, I'm friends with that guy, so I'm saying good night for the YouTube people.
I need a stem. I'm dead.
Oh, she's dead.
I look away.
There's others.
They're pushing my initiation side.
One's cafe, one's initiation done.
Dead.
Op 4, last operator standing.
Oh, last one is...
Just op 4 eliminated. Mission successful.
Did you guys lose that game?
No, we're in overtime now though.
Guy's trying to be my friend!
I can just inside.
Yeah, I didn't know he was there. You ghouly.
Metal.
Dude,
that
metal.
That hole was scary. It was in the wall.
I think Blackbeard's still on. Oh, wait.
Yeah, both bottom middle. Both bottom middle.
I'm watching.
Reload.
I'm above hatch.
Could be inside. Someone needs to go down. One of you guys need to go down. Drop backside, Tabby.
I'm watching from above. I'm running from above.
Oh, CC hatch is open. CC hatch is open.
Yeah, that's fine.
Well, they're in customs. You can kill them. We have a guy on site, we're fine.
No, he knew.
That's crazy.
Just show, Kaver, just show. I'm watching your door on ping. Just show.
He has breach charges.
Watch your far west door.
Breaking barbed wire.
You're going
he's bottom
default.
Metal.
Yeah, I'm gonna try and kill him. I'm gonna try and kill him.
He might be on the side.
He shot drone. In the shot cam. Left side.
He's right below me, I hear him.
Planted an A.
One op 4 remaining.
He's probably gonna what?
Shock. Yo, Ghouli, you gotta make a call out, man. It's like 5 seconds after you die, though. So, like.
Well, that was easy.
Dude, that Blackbeard knew I was there.
I know, you're ready, like.